I've seen you around, but not officially.
I am Dan Kruger. Nice to meet you, Austin. How are you? I turn around and it's just like,
oh yeah.
Thank you.
never seen them before. But for this occasion, we wanted, I asked them to do a program about trees, to respond to the exhibition, basically. And this show by Tim Rossman, you know, it is the first show I thought of for this space. We downsized the front gallery, and as we were looking at this space to do a show, this is really more of an installation. And when you think about it, almost every surface in the room is made of trees, the floor, the ceiling, that wall, the chairs you're sitting on. And so there's a lot of sort of range in these paintings. Tim, do you want to I want you, before you hear the concert, which is your repertoire about trees, to just hear from the artist what the show is about. Step up here, I think. Tim, I know you've done other kinds of work. You've done these really, really detailed architectural models for well-known architects like Philip Johnson, and I've seen other artworks of yours that are more like photorealism, like really detailed, but these have a much more expressive range. Did you start, I presume you started painting trees when you arrived in the Catskills, is that right?
Yes.
And how fast do you paint? It seems like, I know there's much more. This is the tip of the iceberg, right?
You know, it varies, varies greatly in terms of how much time I spend on painting. A few hours, it can take several sittings outside.
And you go out in the elements to do it, right?
I do. Except for the large, obviously the large canvases.
Yeah. You know, and people say that art should change the way you see the world, and I have to say that having been in the Catskills for 10 years, when I look at the landscape now, I see what your paintings show me about it, and I feel like there's a kind of a darkness to it, and I don't know if that's just Washington Irving, my conditioning with Washington Irving, and Legend of Sleepy Hollow, things like that, but I do feel that it's not necessarily a pretty landscape, the Catskills. There's something more kind of challenging about it. Is that how you feel?
Yeah, the compositions are art challenging, and they're endlessly changing in color and the light, and so it's, and there's a lot of chaos in the woods, which I just try to capture those rhythms and colors and expressions.
Yeah, and you don't choose kind of pretty vignettes. I mean, I noticed, like, we were tossing around titles for the show. We called it Hollow because a lot of these trees are hollowed out or damaged or old or weathered, and there's another one there called The Broken Branch, which was another possibility for the title. You're attracted to things that are sort of not perfect, imperfect beauty, right?
Absolutely.
We have to say something more about that.
I guess it's about those shadows and that sort of those deeper, darker rhythms that I pick up on and I want to pursue.
Mm-hmm.
I want to pursue and I want to paint it. And the color is usually, I think, the very first thing that captures my eye.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I go after it.
Right.
And putting it all together in the composition. Yeah, it's the unevenness and the imperfection of nature.
And trees are anthropomorphic. I mean, we think of them as people. I mean, there's a thing in art called pathetic fallacy where you project your own emotions onto inanimate objects like trees or landscape. And I see a lot of that going on here, where you're obviously having some kind of emotional response to what you're looking at.
Absolutely.
Questions from the audience?
So, I actually do.
Yes, okay.
So, is it very local to where we're sitting right now? Because these landscapes look very familiar, like Roxbury.
Well, yeah, I think a lot of the trees and forests around here, they all look familiar.
Yeah.
And you know, you can look one to the next and you can see so many similarities. Most of these trees are really right around our property, with the exception of quite a few, but most of them are around the property. Yeah.
There's one picture in the room that is not painted in the Catskills, and I'll let you try to figure that out as you're watching as you're watching the performance. Yes, maybe one more question. Yes, yeah.
Do you prefer a particular time of day?
Well, early morning is the light is fantastic, and the end of day, I think those are the best times to catch the light and to, yeah, those are my favorite times.
Same as Woodland, you have different times.
I do.
The day,
I do.
Very different. Yeah.
So it's a repertoire of tree songs Noko and Liz will perform. I will mention before we cut to that all works are for sale. So if you'd like to ask me about anything, talk to me afterwards. So thank you, Tim, and without further ado, Noko.
Music and life for the past 2 years, and trying to find a commonality around our work and our backgrounds. And when Kevin told us about the exhibit And to put a program together, we felt dramatically happy because we are exactly exploring the same concepts. We are mountain people from a vast continent called America. I come from Bogota, Colombia, from the mountains of the of Colombia and South America, and this is from the mountains of Virginia, so we're really happy to keep on exploring what we love. So thank you for having us, and I wanted to mention about the first piece I played was prelude by Brazilian composer Heitor Villa-Lobos. He wrote five preludes dedicated to the abundant nature of the Amazon rainforest. So that was a piece directly related to that concept, as an homage to nature in South America.
And so I just sang, I wrote for my mother, and it's about the Twin Peaks that kind of give identity to where I grew up in Virginia. It's the Peaks of Otter, if you've ever been to that area. They actually live in the valley that is called Otter Hill. There's a bunch of hills. So this next song I wrote, because I've lived in cities all my adult life, but I ache for this. This is what I grew up in, and that's why this room is just like hugging me with trees. And so this song is about that, just truly missing what nature gives to the soul, and why am I doing, what am I doing here in this city? Thank you.
Sita Shinara.
talks about a little ant that walks through the forest into the mountains. Hacia el oro que se derrama y se me entrega, tú te duermes pidiendo el cielo, apuntando a la luz con flores y como lazarillos son los sabores en tu jardín de anhelos. Ando como hormiguita por tu espalda, ando por la quebrada dulce de la selva. Vengo de las alturas de tus nalgas, hacia el oro que se derrama y se me entrega. Tú te duermes pidiendo el cielo, apurando a la luz. Reflects in his or her face and makes us smile. It's called Riecinito.
Riecinito se ríe y yo lloro porque
Cuba. So if you feel like dancing, please join us.
Thank you.
Dios sin que yo la viera, alma sola. Bajo la lluvia y el sol muere sola. Songs. The first one is called Asturiana, and this song belongs to a set of 7 Spanish popular songs by Manuel de Falla, great Spanish composer. And this song in particular says, "I was looking for some consolation, and I came to this green tree, to the trunk of this green tree, looking for consolation. And the tree, when he saw me how sad I was, he started crying when he saw me crying." And then the second verse, "We will encourage you to find it because it's even more beautiful." Thank you. province of Colombia, and this is a song by Luis Enrique Aragon, a famous Colombian composer, in the rhythm of bambuco. Bambuco is a traditional rhythm from the mountains of the Andes, where I'm from. So this is a song that talks about that kiss that I stole from the moon.
But there's a lot of migrating people that took their music with them, especially in the 50s and 60s when all the coal mines closed and they moved up north to that region. I was in Chicago for about 10 years, so I got to meet all the folk people in that area too. But this is a band called the Milk Carton Kids. It's a duo of two men from that region. Really, check them out as well. But this song is about, one of them wrote this song about his wife. She was going through some grief. So they went to the north, like super north in Michigan, and it is kind of like this Alaska phenomenon where it just stays light forever. It's like deep into the night. So we're here, we're sharing this with you. It's called North Country Ride. Thank you.
take the north country road.